Now in this lecture we will see how to develop a logic for traffic light control. Now in a traffic light control there is red LED, yellow and green LED. These three LEDs are there. So we will represent these LEDs by the name R, Y and G. Okay. So there are three LEDs. So in the first state, let us assume our red LED is on, yellow LED is off and green LED is off. This is our state 1. And this position will remain as it is for, let us assume, for 10 seconds. Now after this, so this is state 1. Now in the state 2, red LED is still on. Now yellow LED will also on and green is off, and this state will remain as it is for 5 seconds. So this is our state 2. Now in state 2, actually this yellow LED is on to indicate the traffic that after short duration the state of R and state of G is going to change, just to alert the people. So overall we see that red LED is on for 10 seconds and for this 5 seconds. For 15 seconds red LED is on, whereas yellow LED is on only for this 5 seconds. Now system will go in third state. In third state red LED will now off, yellow will also off, and now green LED will on, and this state is again there for 10 seconds. So this is our state number 3. Now from state number 3, system will go to state number 4, and state 4 is red is off, just like your state 3. Now yellow LED will on and green is continuously on from state 3. Now here the yellow LED is on to indicate the traffic that after a short duration green and red LED will change its state, means green will become red, off and red will become on, and this state is there for 5 seconds. So this is state number 4, and after state number 4 again we will go to state number 1. So we can say this is a state diagram for traffic light logic. In this state diagram, red LED in state 1 and state 2 continuously on. So if we count the time, total time on time for the red, it is 15 seconds, whereas LED Y, yellow, is on only for 5 seconds. Now come to state number 3. In state number 3, green is on, red and yellow off. State number 4, green is still on for this 5 seconds. So green in state 3 and state 4, if we include, then green is on for 15 seconds. And here yellow will on in state 4 for 5 seconds. Now let us assume this is our controller 8051, and we are using now 3 pins, pin number 1.0, This is and pin number 1.1 and pin number 1.2. To these three pins we will connect our LEDs. So with pin number 1.0, port 1, pin number 0, here we will connect one LED LED. So this is red LED. So here we will connect 220 ohm resistor. Now at pin number 1.0 we will connect yellow LED. This is yellow. And at port 1 pin number 2 we will connect red, green LED. This is green. So we will do one thing here, we will connect common line. This is plus 5 volt, this is 220 ohm, and this is also 220 ohm resistor. So we have connected these LEDs with, this is our anode terminal and this is cathode. With anode terminal connected to plus 5 volt and cathode terminal is connected to the port pins. So to make the LED on, we have to send a zero value to these ports. And to make LED off, we have to send one value to these ports. So on LED, send binary 0. Off LED, send binary 1. So in this program we will have two delays. One delay for state 1, 10 second, and state 3. Another delay is of 5 seconds for state 2 and for state 4. So we will write two delay subroutines for 10 seconds and 5 seconds. So okay, first we will write our main program from the ORG 0000H. Now our first state is red on. To make red on, I will write the wire. To make the red on, we have to send 0 to port 1.0. So we will write the instruction CLR P 1.0 and we will write the comment also here. Red on. Yellow off, green off. So to make yellow, this LED is red. Yellow is this port 1.0. To make it off, send 1. So set V P 1.1. So this will make yellow off. And to make green off, because in state 1 green is off, 1.0 plus 1.2 is used and we have to set that pin. Set B P 1.2, it will make green off. So this is our state 1. Now system will remain in state 1 for 10 seconds. So now we will transfer the sequence of our program to the subroutine of delay where we have written a delay of 10 seconds. So L call delay 10 seconds. Suppose this is the name of my that subroutine of 10 second delay. So now program will go to a 10 second delay subroutine. Suppose we will write the 10 second subroutine here at location ORG 0050H, right? So this is delay 10 second. So you will write the subroutine afterward, and in the last of the subroutine there is a instruction RET. So this RET will transfer the sequence of program back to the main program and after alcohol instruction. So now controller will come to execute instruction written here, and here we have to write the instruction for state 2. So in state 2 we have to make red LED on. So already red LED is on, so there is no need to write any instruction for making red LED on. Already it is on. Now we have to make yellow on, because in state 1 yellow is off. Now you have to make yellow on. To make yellow on, we have to use pin number 1.1, and to on it we have to send 0. So here we will write the instruction CLR P1.1. So it will make yellow on, and for the green LED we have to make it off, and already in statement it is off, so there is no need to change anything, to write any instruction. Now after writing this instruction, our state 2 is for 5 seconds. So now I will transfer the sequence of program to another subroutine. The label of that subroutine is suppose DELAY delay 5 seconds. And that delay subroutine, let us assume we have written at ORG 0100H. So here the label is delay 5 seconds. So here we will write the instructions to generate a delay of 5 seconds. And the last instruction of this subroutine is RET. Now with the RET, again program sequence will come back to the main program after alcohol instruction. So now program sequence will come to this place. So this is our state 2. Now we have to write the instruction for state 3. In state 3, now red is off. So previously red was on, so now we have to make red off. For making it off, we have to send 1 at pin number 1.0. So here now we will write set B P1.0. So it will make red off. Now yellow also you have to make it off. So again you will write now set B P1.1. And it will make yellow off, because before this state yellow was on, so you have to make it off. And now make green on, and green is connected to port number 1 pin number 2, and to make it on clear that value CLR P1.2. It will make green on. So this is our state 3. And now again system will remain in state 3 for 10 seconds. So again I will write here L call delay 10 seconds. So again program sequence will go to now this delay, where we have written instructions for 10 second delay. In the last there is a RET instruction, again sequence will come back to main program after alcohol here. Now here we have to write the instruction for state 4. This is state 4. In state 4 red, make red off. Already in state 3 it was off, so there is no need to write any instruction. Yellow on. Now make yellow on. Previously it was off, now you have to make it on. So to make yellow on, we have to send 0 value CLR at pin number port 1.1. So this will make yellow on. And in state 4 the green LED should on, and in state 3 also it was on. That's why there is no need to change anything. Okay, so this is our state 4. Now for state 4, system will be in state 4 for 5 seconds. So again I will transfer the sequence of our program to 5 second delay. So L call delay 5 second. So with this instruction, sequence of program will go to this label, and here we have written the instructions of 5 second delay. In the last, RET is there, return will transfer the sequence of program back to the main program after L call delay. Now we will come to this place. So now we have completed one full operation. Now again we have to go to state 1. We have to repeat the sequence. So state 1 is here. So here I will now simply transfer the sequence of our program to first instruction. For this I will use L jump repeat is my label. R-E-P-E-A-T. This is the label. And repeat label has to be written here. This is a repeat. So this is state 1. So now this is our main program. This is our one subroutine to generate 10 second delay. This is another subroutine to generate 5 second delay. Now in this first, now here we have to write a program to generate 10 second delay. So now to write, we will use the timers to generate the delay, and before using the timers we will make certain assumptions. An assumption is first frequency of crystal is 12 megahertz. Now since the frequency of the crystal is 12 megahertz, therefore frequency of timer clock will be frequency of crystal divided by 12, because internally in the timer hardware this crystal frequency will be divided by 12. So here you will get 1 megahertz. So if this is a clock frequency which is connected to the timer, so the timer will get a clock of time period of timer clock. This will be 1 by frequency of timer clock. So this will give 1 microsecond. So this is time period of timer clock. Now out of two timers, which timer we are going to use? So that also we will make the assumptions. We will use, suppose timer number 0, in timer operation in mode 1 software stop. So for this you have to find out the control word for TMOD register and The control board for T mode resistor for this particular selection will be 0000001 in binary. Now we have to calculate. So first we will take calculation for 10 seconds. Calculations for 10 second delay. First we will make this for calculation. So now in last class we have seen that if TH0 and TL0 are 0000H, then we get 66 millisecond delay with normal set of instructions. Now to generate 10 second delay, we have to run that particular loop how many times, that we have to see. So for that we will see 66 millisecond multiply by number of loop is equal to 10 seconds. So with this we will find n is 10 seconds divided by 66 millisecond. I will convert this second into millisecond so that the units in the numerator and denominator should be same. So 10,000 millisecond divided by 66 millisecond. So we will find the value. Now calculations for 5 second delay. So again, those set of instructions which were generating 66 millisecond, obviously for those set of instructions which were generating 66 millisecond delay, the main point we have to make TH0 and TL0000H. So those set of instructions has to be repeated how many times? So 66 millisecond multiplied by number of times loop is equal to 5 seconds. So here again we will find n is equal to 5000 millisecond divided by 66 millisecond. So we will find some value here. We will see those values. First 10,000 divided by 66. It is giving 151.5. So this is 151.5. So I will make it in round figure. So this is 152 decimal. And for 5 seconds. Divide by 66. This is 75.8. So this is 75. So we will make it round figure. So this is 76 in decimal. So these are the values. So now we will write the instruction for generating 10 millisecond delay. So this is delay 10 seconds. So first I will write the instruction move tmod comma hash. In the tmod I will load this value. So in hexadecimal it is 01H. Now I will use one register. In that register I will load this 152. So for that, move R naught comma hash 152D. Now in TH0 and TL0, we will load value 0000H. Move TH0 comma hash 00H. Move TL0 comma hash 00H. Now I will start the timer. To start the timer, we have to set TR0 bit. Set B TR0. So timer will start. Now once the timer will start, we will now monitor timer flag register TF0, timer flag bit TF0 for timer 0. So for this we will write the instruction B1, this is the label, jump no bit TF0 to label B1. So now TF0 will remain executing this instruction till, since TH0 and TL0 are 00, so this instruction will be repeated until the timer 0 reaches to terminal count or overflow, and for that it will take 66 milliseconds. Now once 66 milliseconds will be over, TF0 will high and program will come out from the loop. And now we will decrease the value of R0 by 1. So here, before that we will reset the TF0. CLR TF0 will stop the timer. CLR TR0. And then we will decrease the value of R0. D, J, N, Z, R0. If R0 is not 0, go to level, suppose we write the label B2. This is B2 and B2 label is this, B2. Again, these set of instructions will be generated or will be executed to generate delay of 66 milliseconds. So now these 66 millisecond instruction will run for 152 times. So here we have calculated, if these set of instructions will run for 152 number of times, then 10 second delay will be generated. In the last, program will come out from this loop, and now here we will write RET. So these set of instructions are there for 10 second delay. Same way we will write the same set of instructions for 5 second delay. Only difference will be, here we have taken 152 in R0, and in this subroutine we will take 76 value in R0. So very quickly I will write move tmod comma hash 01H. Move R0 comma hash 76D. Then move TH0 comma hash 00H. Move TL0 comma hash 00H. Then set B TR0, then some different label B3 colon jump no bit TF0 label B3, this label. Then CLR TF0, CLR TR0, DJNZ R0 comma some label B4, and this is the label B4, and in the last RET. So you write this instruction, these instruction, these instruction, and after writing the last instruction you write end. So this end indicates the assembler that this is the end of our program, assembly language program. So this is the all instructions which are required for a traffic light logic controller.